I am a professional.
Oh.
I made my debut a week before the war at Town Hall. Jeffrey Meredith, you see?
Jeffrey Meredith and what? Why, it says you were brilliant. Forgive me, Jeff, I should have known.
She played the cello. I was going to appear with the Philharmonic. I didn't, but I have the contract to prove I might have.
But you never play, Jeff. I would love to hear you. Please, go on.
No, I don't like to be stared at.
Oh, well, I'll look the other way and listen, Jeff.
I'd rather not. I'm not ready to face people. Please, don't insist.
I wouldn't dream of it.
Thank you. Can you keep a secret?
About 10 minutes.
Dr. Emmett, he isn't a real doctor at all.
No? What is he?
He's a patient, just like Mrs. Patty.
Oh, do you think so?
For 5 years now, he's promised to give me a new face.
No, he's a doctor, Jeff. It says so on his office door. He wouldn't lie.
Do you believe a man is what he claims to be?
Well, I am a trusting soul. I try to believe the best of people.
Well, it's best to believe the worst. If you believe the worst, oh, then the worst is only half bad at best. And the best is no worse than expected. It's best to believe the worst.
You know, Jeffrey, that's just obscure enough to be profound. What does it mean?
It's simple, really. If a man says he's wise, well, you'll say he's a fool. If he says he's a fool, then you'll believe him.
Well, only a fool claims to be wise.
Exactly, which proves I'm right. Dr. Emmett is a fool. He claims to be a doctor. The war was over 5 years ago, and where's his miracle?
Some things take a long time to heal, Jeffrey.
Oh, I can't wait much longer. I'm getting old. I'll be 26 soon.
Oh, that's ancient. Why don't you forget your appearance and play anyhow? Don't condemn your audience before you give them a chance to be kind.
Just take one look at me and tell me an audience wouldn't shudder at the sight of me. Look. Do you see?
I see nothing to hide, Jeffrey.
Dr. Emmett told you what to say.
No, he didn't. I promise. But I would trust him if I were you. Just give him a little more time.
All right. I'll give him 5 years more.
That's fair enough.
Do you know something?
Not a thing. I'm only awed by the magnitude of what I don't know.
Well, I wouldn't tell this to anyone else. But Hannibal can't really play the violin.
No.
Yes.
Well, of course, I'm tone deaf.
You know something else? Sometimes I wish I were.
Well, you're a sweet boy to pretend.
Poor Hannibal can't play, yet he does. And I really can, but I won't. Don't you think that's funny?
Not very.
Right off my coffee. You know there's no rat in the hall.
That's Mrs. Savage,
too much again.
Well, you really shouldn't exercise right after a full meal.
I know, but if I wait till I'm comfortable, my conscience won't needle me.
Are you sure that there haven't been any phone calls or messages for me today?
Positive.
Well, is it possible to send to the village and for the evening newspaper?
Well, if you'll serve the coffee, I'll go ask Dr. Emmett.
Oh, gladly.
Florence hasn't been served.
Oh, don't stand on manners, Jeff. Miss Willie knows just how you like your coffee. I'll serve myself.
Very well, thank you.
You're annoyed.
Miss Willie, you single me out for attention. It's not fair and it makes me uncomfortable.
Jeff, I'm so tired tonight. I just didn't remember. Please forgive me.
It's okay. I forget too.
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the best dressed of them all? Fairy who?
Bring in your coffee, Fairy.
Yes, please. Do you think this dress does anything for me? I made it myself.
It's sheer delight, dear. Sugar?
Five. I didn't have time to finish it, you see. I put it together with pins.
No, thank you.
Would you like to know a trick that makes that exercise more enjoyable, Hannibal?
An enjoyable way of losing weight has yet to be invented.
Well, I know of an improvement. All you need is a deck of cards.
I went to a fortune teller when I was 14 years old. Everything he told me turned out wrong. I never believed in cards after that.
Fairy, fairy, fairy.
Now throw it up in the air.
Why?
To lose weight. Now bend over and pick them up one by one. One by one.
I like that. It's toy, you know.
I learned it in a beauty course.
You know, thank you, Mrs. Savage. This is a great improvement. Oh, much. You know, man was made all wrong. His stomach should be in the back instead of the front. And it wouldn't get in the way when he bends over. And when he kneels, his legs go to the side. They should fall neatly behind him. Why is his nose in the front? It should be in the back so he can kiss easier.
Oh, you're so right, Hannibal.
God was in a hurry.